Hi everyone, this is HJ. Welcome back to Let's Play Ogre Battle 64. This is it. This right here, this is going to be the end of Alba. I know you're all excited for it. I know so many people watch my Ogre Battle videos that they just can't contain their excitement, but this is finally it. This is the moment we've been waiting for, the end of Alba. This is a momentous occasion, something we should all be very excited and happy for, because, well, this means there's new plot and stuff, and there's gonna be like 10-15 minutes of cutscene, and I'm gonna put on my acting hat and epically read 10-15 minutes of cutscene for you. Trust me, it'll be good. I'm in the awesome state of mind right now, so we're gonna do that, and you're gonna be like, holy crap, HJ, you shouldn't talk anymore. I'll probably be like, you're right. That's just too damn bad. So, I forget how long we actually have to wait until we get to the end. If I figured out the format I'm going to do in the future when I do more Ogre Battle stuff. Also, couldn't let that witch sit by herself. Come on, she's only got 2 HP. This is a no-brainer. But I figured out the format. What I'm going to do is I'm going to do every mission, I guess, in Ogre Battle in 3 parts. So there's only going to be 3 videos, so that way it'll be a bit easier, a bit better to manage, and there'll be a whole lot less commentary. Because we all know that whatever I say here, nobody gives a shit about. I mean, if you do great, but, you know, in all honesty, people who watch Let's Play, they want to see how I react to the plot, and how I conduct myself in battle. This filler stuff, and going to every stronghold and killing everybody, you know, that's not as important. So, the way I'm going to do the videos from now on is going to be 3 parts. The first part's going to be any organized screen I have to do, and the mission intro, and maybe like the first 2 or 3 minutes of me setting everybody up and telling them where to go. Part 2 is just going to be me with like a x4 multiplier, speeding through all the crap and stopping for important events like random cutscenes along the way, or finding troops, or going shopping, or things that I should warrant you knowing, but otherwise it'll just be me running through it very quickly, probably talking over it, explaining what's going on. And then part 3 is just going to be the final battle and any remaining cutscenes after. You know, so this way, we're not sitting there like, oh, well, no, I'm going to fight some guys, and then I'm going to fight some more guys, and then I'm going to camp and rest and fight some more guys. Like, no, we're going to do it like x12 speed. You're not even going to wonder what's happening, because it's not going to matter as much. I'm going to say, hey, we're fighting guys. Awesome, whatever. Moving on. This is good, so hopefully that'll make that better for everyone, and this will also allow me to go, okay, I'm more enthusiastic about doing Ogre Battle because I don't have to come up with 5 videos worth of crap. I mean, the hell, I talked about, like, Maslow's hierarchy of needs or whatever. That was retarded. Who let me do that? It's probably the booze. So, we decide to heal up HJ because I want to send him in for the final battle. At least I'm pretty sure I do, so we send him forward, and it's cutscene time. I'll try and get all dramatic for you. Shit! How could this happen? Even I was branded as an insurgent. General Goddessless. Good old T14 games. I guess this is the end of your career. You did quite well for yourself, don't you think? Sir Baldwin, what have you done? No, you deceived me. What did I do? You had your chance. You just didn't put your power to good use. For those vile abominations, my family was... Slap. Silence. It was you who made up your mind to sacrifice your family. You willingly sacrificed your family, and you'd blame me for your misdeeds? It turned out this was all you were capable of. I'm sure glad to know you're useful of us. Someone desire blah 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 fruit of the netherworld. Delicious fruit of the netherworld. I'm afraid I must be going now. You can't do anything without our council. You're angry at me or at yourself. Channel that rage straight back at the Revolutionary Army. Perhaps you can gain power too. So, fruit of the netherworld. Some people made some shady deals with some bad stuff. And now we're here to ruin everything. HJ, if only you hadn't betrayed me. What meaning did my life hold? You can't imagine what I run through for this. Do you understand my pain? Do you have to protect anything at all costs, even if you had to sacrifice your own family? He's glowing all purpley. Arg! I'll just bring my dragon right onside. It's cool, don't worry about it. And he's probably got the worst formation ever because, well, look at where he's chilling. Toting his sword back and forth. Hey, look. Boosh. Boosh. Double fireball. Boosh. He uses a move called Infest, and I guess it's just a light damaging move for 10. But guess what? You did. Wish I had my staples button. You know, click. That was easy. I really need to find that. I will reach the top. Blair. So, like, what do his guards do after? Do they just kind of chill there, or do we capture them, or what's the deal with them? I've never figured that out. Congratulations. And we get the E-Stock, which is his plate sword thingy, and $3,000 and 8 midgets to add to the army. So good stuff. And now, dramatic cutscene time. Well done, HJ. Why, thank you. I thank you. Frederick, did you do the right thing? Many people were hurt. The entire kingdom of Lotus Empire, blah, blah, blah. Battles will intensify and its whole number of casualties. Got the slightest of clue, all shrouded in mystery. Can the revolutionary army overcome these obstacles? Honestly, we are in a difficult situation, but don't you think the important thing now is to do our best? The only actual solution is obvious. The future, our future, is yet to be told. Listen, HJ, to the people's cheers. We do know the cheers you hear rejoicing, result of what we've done. Oh yeah, terrible cheering sounds, I don't know if you can hear them, but it's like, yay, and it's all quiet and shit. Because recording MP3 files on an N64 cartridge. Awesome. So we're going to save, like I said, that's the end of Chapter 1. Dardanelle, the crossroads, last time we saved, but Alba's done. A few days after liberation of the southern region. The Triumvirate of the Holy Lotus Empire ordered the King of Flatness to eliminate the Revolutionary Army. That's us, by the way. The King sent orders to both the Eastern and the Western Divisions. Two months later. Quite an army. Ching, ching, ching. For Victora! Immediately after the appointment of the new general, the Western Division advanced on Alba. After a number of skirmishes, the full-scale battle between the Western Division and Revolutionary Army is thought to take place in the near future. Although the Eastern Orthodox Church received the same instructions, it chose to remain silent in the matter. Chapter 2. In a world shrouded in darkness, no path can be found. I kind of feel like I should be doing, like, the epic movie announcer's voice. In a world of darkness! My lord, we should go back. Thank you, Seth. What is my father's intention? What am I to do in witness? He wants me to fight Lotus? What should I do? How can I gain his approval? Man, don't I know about that? Gaining father's approval. There you are, my lord. I've been looking for you. I would have used a different voice had I known it was him. I beg your pardon for being late. This is to commemorate your appointment as general. Please accept this holy sword of the royal family. I brought this maiden to take care of your personal needs. Though she is of humble origins, I believe she is able to suit you in both age and features. Olay. What is your name? Mari Colin, at your service. Why? I know you. Who are you? I really want to know. An earthquake? Oh. It seems the guy has taken a liking to our new general as well. God, so many cutscenes. Southern region. Akka Castle. We are knights of the round table. Dance whenever able. Still in activity. The Eastern Orthodox Church. The Central Division is keeping a close watch over the area, presumably prevent us from making contact with them. The Eastern region led by Eastern Orthodox Church has opposed the church in the past. It can't be helped. They seem to have no intention of following the blah 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 with us or against us. I see. What is the status of the Western Division? Since the appointment of Prince Yumel as the commander of Western Division, the troops have advanced to the border 5 times. It's the largest force we've encountered, then it was blah 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 a few next days, whatever. It's supposed to be Dio, by the way. The Western Division bears blah blah blah, there's no way we can avoid this battle. Like the Southern Region, there's an area in the Western Division which people aren't enslaved. Why don't we liberate them and join forces? Sounds fair enough. Checking about the mining facility in Ever Heights, most of them are bulk humans. Hoylo Semper will surely respond in kind. That's convenient, isn't it? Let the Western Division Lotus a little give and take. Zavek! How can you say that? Are you suggesting that we use them? Absolutely. I thought we were going to abolish the class system and blah blah blah. They should be our allies and not a tool. Shut up. So what if your operation was a success? You've got no right to talk shit to me. My only concern is achieving our goal, to win this war. We set them free and they help us. Is that wrong? We fight together. It's all about victory. It's important to win battles, but that is not our goal. Winning battles lets us quickly achieve our goals, but the only thing we'd get is short-lived peace. And tell me what the hell I'm supposed to do. We can't contact the Eastern Orthodox Church, and Western Division is only a few days away, and blah blah blah, there's Lotus. Talking about our ideals doesn't improve our situation, or what, you gonna kill us all? We're gonna fight them anyway. Pushing them back to the Western region isn't enough. We should advance to their territory, we free the bulk humans while we're at it, and prepare for Lotus attack. That's all for the sake of the revolution. You have a problem with this, Frederick? Hey, Shay. Head west to stop the advancement of the Western Division. And when others on standby, I will contact each of you later about the plan. Very dramatic. Do you still have something to say to me? Frederick, you're our leader. You understand, right? My job is to slay foes. What's your job? Is it to pursue ideals or live in reality? Make up your mind, will you? You'll understand, eventually, the reality of it all. The reality that we have to face. Alrighty. So, L was done. End of chapter 1 cutscene. It was awesome. That's the beginning of chapter 2. We have to head west. Take care of that. So, I want to thank you guys for watching. We'll see you next time. Let's play Ogre Battle 64.